We live in a violent universe, full of black holes devouring titanic amounts of matter, and then there's galaxies colliding, sparking off massive amounts of star formation, all the way to entire planets crashing into each other. But there is one cataclysm that could be possible that would utterly dwarf even the most violent events in the universe. It's if the universe destroys itself entirely, or something else does. The idea that this could happen is rooted in some very mundane everyday physics. When an atom is excited and in an elevated energy level, it can decay to a lower energy level, emitting a photon in the process. This may be true of the universe as well, in that the quantum vacuum could also have a lower energy state. This involves dark energy having a quantum origin, which is currently the general consensus. This may mean that the universe itself is excited, and there may be other levels, and it may not be at the lowest one, and thus would not be completely stable. That means that at any time, it could decay to a lower energy state, and that would be beyond catastrophic on the biggest scale there is. It would be the apocalypse of the universe. It would start at some point in the universe, and then radiate out at almost the speed of light, traveling in all directions. The titanic amounts of energy created by the process would form a shockwave, utterly destroying anything and everything in its path, with absolutely no warning. No one would see the shockwave coming until it reached them, and instantly destroyed them, leaving behind an altered universe with altered laws of physics, such that even matter itself may no longer be able to exist. This process of destruction would take an enormous amount of time to accomplish, as the universe is unbelievably large and possibly even infinite. So it may even be that this has already happened, but could be outside the observable universe for all we know. An infinite universe cannot be destroyed by a finite expanding process, just parts of it can. So if the universe is infinite, it may resemble a huge piece of Swiss cheese. If it's not infinite, it may be a self-consuming piece of cheese, with ever-growing holes gobbling it all up, and we are blissfully unaware that the universe is destroying itself as we speak. And there is a variant of the scenario first proposed by physicist Edward Witten. In this scenario, the expanding hole doesn't even contain a lower energy quantum vacuum, but absolutely nothing. The expanding void of nothing would consume everything until there was nothing left to consume, and what's left is a completely empty universe. Perhaps this is how cosmology works. A universe is born, consumes itself, and then the blackness just awaits a new Big Bang going off, in a situation resembling the conformal cyclic cosmology of Roger Penrose. So do we see bubbles of nothing in the universe? Well, yes, but it's not likely to be due to this issue. It's actually worse. This involves the cold spot in the cosmic microwave background radiation. This cold spot should not be. The CMB is very uniform, ridiculously so, with only very tiny temperature variations defining it. These variations are highly important. They are what allowed the universe to clump together after the Big Bang and form up. Had the tiny variations not been present, the universe would have been perfectly homogeneous, and unable to clump, with all the matter being equally distant and unable to clump together to form hydrogen nebulas and eventually stars. But the cold spot is something on the order of 6 times colder than any other of the many temperature anomalies in the CMB. There haven't been very many good explanations for the presence of the cold spot, so the theories got increasingly speculative, but some do actually seem testable. One is that our universe flat out collided with another universe entirely. This has some spooky implications. Though no observational evidence of the predicted gravitational waves and polarization in the CMB that should result from that have been found. And if that possibility of colliding universes can happen, then the idea of the universe itself being eaten by another larger universe comes on the table. What would happen if that occurred? Would everything in the universe suddenly vanish? What if the laws of physics of that universe were different, and everything suddenly changed? It's a complete unknown whether events outside of our universe could affect us inside it. I've done past videos on a discrepancy called the Axis of Evil, where the overall temperature of the CMB is different north and south, and how this very strange feature somehow lines up with the plane of the solar system. That also should not be. But one thing that could cause it, possibly, is if the universe were being compressed by something, and just so happens to line up with a plane of the solar system entirely by chance. And there are the ideas of other universes existing on top of us, hovering just above us, imperceptibly, occupying the same space. But ultimately, it's not known what the CMB hole is. Another option is that it's a kind of a hole in the universe looking out onto the multiverse. We would be seeing what was before the Big Bang, potentially opening up a way to probe the multiverse itself and see what was here before the universe existed. But it's also possible that we are the giant monster universe gobbling up smaller universes. Here our universe is the blundering giant zombie wandering around the multiverse, destroying other smaller universes. For all we know, inhabited by poor schmoes, going about their business only to be eaten by the human universe and cease to exist. All while we happily drink coffee over a nice donut, not giving a single thought as to what might be happening out there in the horrific multiverse. But this all leads to an even more disturbing question. Is the universe even really here? In quantum mechanics, particles are known to exist in superpositions, many different quantum states at once. This is the basis for Erwin Schrödinger's famous cat. It's both dead and alive at the same time, until you open the box and collapse its superposition. When you scale that up, the universe itself should also have a superposition. But it appears to be collapsed. We do not seem to exist in a quantum superposition state. So why is that? No one knows. The situation basically has been that it must get collapsed somewhere along the way, and that's that. But there has to be a reason, and the current favorite is called decoherence. This in a nutshell says that information leaks out, and that individual particles can be isolated enough to pull it off, but as a whole, everything decoheres, and cats do not exist in uncollapsed superpositions. That works well for cats, but not universes. Because for the universe's superposition to collapse in this manner, then information must be leaking out of it. But into what? If there isn't a multiverse, or something out there for that to happen, the universe gets very weird. It means on its face that its superposition must be collapsed by observers, in other words us, or by some unknown process. The universe is not there when we are not looking at it. And if we are alone and life on Earth ended, maybe the universe would cease to exist. This, of course, makes no sense. Obviously, the universe was here before we were, so that led physicists to look at different possibilities. One of these involves the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics. This is where the universe splits into literally many worlds, each almost identical to each other. You would have a counterpart in another universe that had a very different breakfast than you had. But otherwise, everything would be identical, and these universes would be splitting off constantly with slightly different occurrences. This may conveniently give a place for the universe to leak information to, thus collapsing its superposition. But that leaves one final enormous question. What exactly is the universe? The conventional answer to this is that it's everything that was, is, or ever will be, and that includes us. We're every bit as much a part of the universe as an asteroid. And that also includes our consciousness. But it could be more mundane than that, if you want to call this mundane. There is one idea out there that the universe shares some characteristics with black holes. Is it possible that we actually do live inside a black hole? And while that's on the one hand somewhat of a disturbing notion, on the other hand, we know that black holes are very stable things and take absolutely enormous amounts of time to evaporate. They do indeed devour matter, but they don't devour themselves. In that case, happily, the universe won't be self-destructing anytime soon. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently addressing the problem of carrots. Oh, there's that music.
John?
Anna, we've talked about this. You're not supposed to be over here.
I thought you might like to know. The opossum is disassembling your beard trimmer. And the sink is on fire.
You see what I have to deal with here? And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.
Live.